In this tutorial, I'm going to show you how to create a dynamic tentacle. It responds to gravity and physics, and you can do all kinds of awesome stuff with it. The first part of this tutorial is going to be creating the skeleton, all the parts that make the tentacle move. In the second part, I'm going to show you how to turn this moving spline into an actual tentacle. Now, the first thing you do is you create a join chain. Create about 5 different points and make sure that you line them all up. Once you have your join chain, you have to grab all these different joints and then go to character, conversion, joints to spline. Now what you end up with is a spline that lines up exactly with your joint. The next thing you do is you create an arcade spline. You attach it to the join chain. Now make sure that you point it to the end, which is joint 4 in this case. And make sure that you point to the spline that it affects, which is, of course, the only one spline. The next thing you do is you click handles. You click a couple of times until you have 5. Then create all the necessary nulls by clicking the create button. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. Now we have 5 different nulls. We turn them all into circles, make them visible. So once you have these nulls, you stack them up in the same way that you did with the joints. So now you have 2 chains, the join chain and the null chain. Add the arcade tag to the null chain. Now make sure you point to the end of the null chain, which in this case is null 4. Now when I click dynamics and I enable them and then I press play, now you see I can move this tentacle around and the physics will do their job. You can see I can wave to the camera, hi. Now you can modify this tentacle to suit your needs, whatever it is. You can, for example, decrease the strength. When I do that, you'll see that it becomes a lot weaker and starts hanging around a little bit, starts to become a very lazy tentacle. Also increase the strength and make it a little bit stronger, like this. I can the rotation hold, you'll see it will bend a lot more. Also I can increase the drag, make it move a little bit slower, like if this was a squid creature, it would be underwater. So lots of different ways that you can make this tentacle move. There are lots of different ways to model a tentacle. In this tutorial, I'm going to show you the easiest one, which is to just grab a sweep. It should be right over here. And create a circle as well. So you have both a spline and a circle. If I drag it in here, you'll see this is a little bit too bulky. Have to shrink it down a little bit to about this size. That looks good. As you can see, this looks a little bit like one of those wavy guys in front of the gas station. It's another fun way to use this tentacle, but it's not what we want right now, so I'm going to see if I can change this. So all you have to do for that is set spline type from linear to B-spline. But as you can see, it still has a stump, like this is not good yet, so we need to make sure that it ends like a tentacle. It goes from wide to small. The way you can do that is open up the sweep and then go into the details. There is a graph right here, which is the scale graph. And you can just scale it down until it looks like a tentacle. I made a simple material for my tentacle. I decided to make it sort of minty green. Another way to control this tentacle is by creating a goal. In that case, you have to open the IK expression, click on tag, and then click on add goal. I'm turning my goal into a cube, so I can see exactly where it is in 3D. The next thing you can do is to create a pole. The pole determines what direction the tentacle will bend to. Creating a pole is very simple. You just open the IK tag and then you click add pole. So using both the pole as well as the goal, I can make this tentacle move in very exact ways. Now we have this awesome tentacle. Let's see what we can do with it. I flash forwarded this next part to show you some examples of what you can do. So I hope this tutorial helps you, and if you have any questions for me, let me know in the comments. Now good luck with these tentacles, and be careful not to summon Cthulhu.